To show you the project. Hi everyone, it's Jerry Ann with scrapandstampcreations.blogspot.com, and tonight we are doing a throwback to 2012 project that I created on a Ustream. And since photo folios and things like that, photo kind of folio mini album kind of stuff are really popular right now, and everybody seems to be doing it, I thought I would go back and revisit this project. And the cool part about it is a fourfold. It is 9 inches by 4 inches. It's really simple and easy, and it's got lots of space for photos. It's a nice little brag book. You could do all kinds of stuff with it. All right, so here's the front cover. Very just sporadic, not very fancy. And as I was cleaning up and putting everything in the new china cabinet, I came back across this one and thought, oh, we really should do this. So when you open it up, you have three little envelopes here on this side to put little note cards in, little photos, any of those. So we're going to use our envelope punch board in order to make that. On this side, we have a picture spot or a couple of little picture spots and a journaling spot. And we open again, and you have four photo spots. These are 3x4 photo mats. And you open again, and we have two tags that fit in this piece here, as well as this is an old-fashioned waterfall that kind of pulls. We're actually going to do this a little differently. So, but this is kind of a flashback. It's a really easy, simple binding system. I basically have kind of written down some of the, some of the pieces to it. So I'm going to go ahead and pop us out just a little so you guys can see a little more of the screen. And then the first things, and I was going to build one, and then I was like, no, because I really just want to get it done. And that. So what you are going to need are four pieces of chipboard. And I took my black marker upstairs to label my son's stuff for camp, because Harrison's going to camp. Yay! Love the kid, but it's nice he's at camp. Hold on, I'm looking for a Sharpie or something that'll write on this cardstock. Here we go. Nope. Be nice to find a big brush pen right at the moment. Here we go. They do, and they're really nice. All right. So this is chipboard, and this is 4 inches, and this is 9 inches. Okay? And you're going to need four pieces. Yeah, he goes to camp next week, too. I'm pretty excited. All right, do we have that? Four pieces at 4x9. Okay, and that's the only pieces you're going to need for chipboard. Oh, I might have to cut another one because we use the edges of these. Ah, don't write on them like this. I have to cut another little piece of that. You're going to need, out of your cardstock for the collection, you are going to need 8 pieces at 8 7/8 by 3 7/8. Okay, 8 7/8 long, 3 7/8 wide, and you're going to need 8 pieces. So I cut up a few of the pieces. They're double-sided, so that makes it all good. No, because it's on each side, because these are going to fit like, ooh, I might be able, yep, it looks like I'm going to be able to make it. It gives a little 1/8 inch border. We're using both sides of those. Okay? So eight of those, 8 7/8 by 3 7/8. Okay? Got that, guys? You are going to need 2 pieces of 2.5 by 9. 2.5 by 9. You're going to need 2 pieces. And you're going to need a piece at 2.25 by 9. So you're going to need 3 kind of binding pieces. Okay, so that's what my binding is. You are going to need 3 pieces. Yes, I am recording. And once I get done, I will be taking some photos, and we'll get all of the measurements up on my website, on my blog, and on my blog and on the Facebook page. You're going to need 3 pieces of 5.5 by 5.5, and these are for your envelopes. So here is 1 5.5 by 5.5. So I've got 1 out of Lagoon. One out of Juniper. And 1 out of Sweet Leaf. And these are for our envelopes, 5.5 by 5.5. Okay. We also need 6 photo mats that are 4 inches by 3 inches. We need 6 of those. I'm going to do 2 out of each of these. Inches by 3 inches. So there's 2, 4, and then out of the Lagoon. Almost cut that one completely wrong. All right. Karen, Internet Explorer never works on Ustream. You have to go to Chrome or Firefox. All right, so those are our photo mats. We need a photo mat at 6 by 3.5. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. 6 inches by 3.5, and I'm using my Sweet Leaf for that one. All right, and then the last pieces we need are, I'm going to use some of the craft card stuff that comes with the Workshop on the Go, and the 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Five. All right. So I'm going to cut one. I need 5 pieces that are 3.5 by 5.5. Okay. 3.5 by 5.5. So 3.5 by 5.5, And these are the photo fall, the photo waterfall. 3.5 by 5.5. That was 3.5 by 5.5. Oh, 1, 2, 3, that's fine. 3.5 by 5.5. And then we also are going to have a piece of this craft. So I'm just sticking my extra pieces back in my envelope for my Ziploc bag that our kits come in, so that all the pieces are together, and I still have lots and lots and lots. 3.5 by 5.5. All right, so the colors are going to be really pretty. I'm excited. All right, the workshop on the go, which is what you need to make this, is G1072. All right. Oh, and I forgot to tell you who the new hostess was going to be. Where did her little ticket thingy go? The new hostess for this month, starting this evening or tomorrow, the new hostess for the month is Gail Martinez. Yay, the new hostess. These are kits that are that Close to My Heart puts together. So everything you get in the kit, and I should have gone over that, is you'll get, I can't remember if this one has 15 or 16 pieces of cardstock, which is both pattern and, I'm trying to think, hold on, let me see. You get 15 sheets of cardstock, so you're going to get My Reflections Skylark paper pack. You'll get the Workshop stamp set, which is a D-size stamp set, which I have to go dig out. 3 additional cardstock sheets, which is 2 Whisper and 1 White Daisy. You're going to get the Skylark assortment, which is... this little piece here, and it's all these little itty-bitty pieces. These pieces here. And you also are going to get slate striped twist ties. And you do, this is actually a workshop on the go, so it makes 4 two-page layouts. And so here is 2 of the layouts, and in the catalog, the 2 others. So page 22 and 23, you can make those. But I normally do 8-page layouts with these. However, this kit I found a little hard because some of the paper really was very directional and very kind of, I don't know. I just struggled with it a bit. But I do have a new one set. We're going to use the Ariana collection next. So that'll be the last one. And before I'm able to show you guys the new catalog and get those all out and make an announcement. I also purchased the Skylark Compliments, which is X7177C. This goes right with it, and it is perfect. Absolutely perfect. Okay? So, now that we have everything cut for our thing, we are going to, you guys will never guess, Close to My Heart came out with a scoreboard, which is pretty much smaller than the Martha Stewart one. It's a card size one. And that'll come out in the new catalog, which I'm totally excited about. Yep. Oh, now I've got a bee in the house. Where is the cats? Martha, call the cats. Well, and if you have the paper collection, you're great. And at the card kit, you need a couple extra pieces of paper. However, you can just find some cardstock that fits your collection and kind of go from there. All right, guys, so On the waterfall pieces that you have five that are 3.5 by 5.5, we're going to score on the 5.5 inch side. We're going to score at 1/2 inch. Okay? 1/2 inch on all of these pieces. This is going to create this is our waterfall pieces. All right, on our binding pieces, that's these ones that are 9 inches long by 2.5 and 2.25. We are going to use the long side. So at 2.5 inches, we're going to score 1 inch on each side. So we're going to score 1 inch, flip it over, and score 1 inch. Okay, so you get one inch on each side. Okay, and you're going to do that with all these pieces. So on the 1/2 inch, you're going to have 1/2 inch on two of them and 1/4 inch on one. Okay. All right. So that's it for the scoring for this whole thing. Wow, you guys, we're like already cut and ready to go. All right, so let's make our cute little, let's make our envelopes out of our 5x5. So we're making a 2.5 by 3.5 inch envelope, which calls for a 5x5 piece, a 5.5 by 5.5 inch piece of paper. And I'm ducking because, yeah. Hey, Dave.
Yeah.
You want to grab the fly swatter? I have a bee. The kind that's buzzing around. And not that I want to hurt the bee. I just would like it to go away. Oh, maybe it's not a bee. Maybe it's a big old fly. I thought it was yellow. All right. 5.5 by 5.5, we're going to punch at 2 3/4, or 2 3/8, 2 3/8. We're going to flip it completely around and do 2 3/8 again. Oh, wait, 2 3/8 and score. Sorry. Ooh, it needs to go away.
Water is.
It's hanging. There's one hanging where the dog leashes are.
I didn't see it there. I'll look again.
All right. Well, I'll be protected with my...
Not there.
I'll protect myself with my Tim Holtz ruler then. We're going to flip it completely over and punch again at 2 3/8. And score. Oops. And then we're going to line up our score line and punch again. And do. And we're going to line up on our punch line. And punch again. So this makes our little envelope. And I hope that that is... Why is that too big? Because it makes a 4-inch envelope. All right. All right. I lied, and we have to use a 5x5 piece of paper. All right. Me and my Tim Holtz ruler are going to nail that thing. All right, this one's too big. There's a good reason to be a consultant, because then you have extra paper, but I'm just going to use a piece of this slate to cut the next one out. All right. I'm still learning my punch board. I know they've been out forever, but you guys, I'm still like... All right, so 2 3/8, punch and score, flip it all the way over at 2 3/8, punch and score, flip it back over and line up the vertical or the lines, punch and score, and do the same on the opposite side. And now it should be, now it's square. Maybe I'm not supposed to be turning. Oh, you guys, this punch board is gonna be the death of me. All right, 2 3/8. See, 2 3/8. All right, somebody needs to tell me what I'm doing wrong. All right. I got it, guys. If you read the directions on the scoreboard, it works. All right. There we go. But this is still a little big. But you know what? We'll be fine. No, they're the same size. All right. We're going to use that paper. I don't care. Yep. Again, it's, you know, next time I'm just going to cut them out. I'm going to just cut it out of the Cricut because there's pretty nice little things. So, I don't know. We may have to figure out a way to nest these puppies up or something, but we'll figure it out. So, they do work. Line. Almost did that a second time. I need an envelope punch board class because even watching the videos, I'm still not getting anything. Fine, we're using it this way. We got three of them. That thing is back. All right, this one and this one we'll have to figure out something for. All right, so we have three envelopes. We used a 5x5 page. All right. There is a gift one that says 2 by 3.5 or something. I'm just, yeah. We're using these because I created them. That size. We'll just live. All right, guys. So, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to prep all our stuff. I'm going to go ahead and fold over our pieces, give it a nice crease with a bone folder, and find some score tape. And go ahead and add our score tape to the little flap. Okay? So as you can see, we got a little flap. I don't know. We are creating a folio open with little envelopes and a photo spot. And open again for 4 photos and photos and a waterfall and some pockets. This I originally did in 2012. It's kind of fun. It's just a throwback project. I thought it would be cute with this paper. Actually, if I was really thinking about it, I would have done the patriotic paper I have. All those wonderful black and white photos of my grandpa. I still might go and do that. It's a really easy project. I know you guys are like, yes, for who? But you guys see, I fight with the envelope punch board. Just like you. I have not mastered that yet. All right, so here are 5 pieces that are going to be our flip down pages, you know, that kind of thing. It's going to be our flippy waterfall. So. Yep. All right. So, what we need next, in order to do this is our half inch piece, this is a half inch piece, and this is our quarter inch piece. So we're going to take our chipboard pieces, which are 4 by 9, and we are going to take and decide what we want on the outside. I want this little stripe on the outside. So what I am going to do is I'm going to take my score tape and I'm going to move this out of the way and I'm going to line the edge of the paper on both sides. Thanks. I'm glad that I can show you that I can do that. New score tape. Yay. And I'm going to line each of these pieces like that. Alright, so now we have the edge of all of our paper. These are our bindings. Now we're going to take we're going to take each of our pieces here And for three of the pieces, let's see. This piece gets one side. This piece gets two sides. Page number one gets one side, page number two gets two sides, page number three gets two sides along the long side. There is not another how-to book coming out this catalog, so we are going to start doing layouts from the Make It From Your Heart Volume 1 with the 8-page layouts. And we'll do Ariana next week. And page number four only has one side. Okay. All right. We're going to put this board away. All right. So we have page one, page two, page three, and page four. Okay. So we have a half, and a quarter. Okay. Half inch, quarter inch gussets. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we are going to take our pieces. You're going to pull off the adhesive. You're going to take and go ahead and fold this piece here. And you are going to line this up close to the line without going over. Sometimes the best way to do that is to kind of make it into a little fold like that. So we have, this is page one. Now we have page two. We're going to go ahead and do the same thing. Line it up. So now we have two pieces that have a fold. Okay? The nice pretty inside. Or outside, depending on how we choose to use these. We can always do whatever. Alright. For the next one, this is another half an inch one. We're going to go ahead and fold our piece up. Take off our piece. And fold. Okay? We're going to do the same thing with this. We're going to fold this over. Give it a good crease. You know, either way works. You're gonna lane it over, fold it up. Voila. Then we're gonna do exactly the same thing. We're gonna fold on each side, because this is our little one. This is the quarter inch one. Just want to make sure my pieces are on the right side without going over the corners. There we go. Okay. All right, so now we have our base and our little hingy parts, okay? Except for now I've got glue on one side that I shouldn't. I did put score tape on both the edges, and now I'm going to go back through and reinforce them because there are no, I just wanted it all to lay flat. Just an extra precaution for it to be sturdy and stuck. And I think I stuck the wrong piece. Yep, see? These two pieces should not be together. I wasn't following the score tape. I was following the paper on this one. We'll go back and fix it. It's no big deal. I'm going to try and pick it up. Not gonna. Nope, don't have any undo. Usually I just kind of go with it. All right, well, we'll see how this all works. So then this one right here has a piece. And this one here has a piece. So I think that's all the pieces there are now stuck. Okay. Now I'm going to try really hard to get this piece off. And since my chipboard is kind of glossy, I'm able to get that up. Woohoo! All right. So the only other thing I have is this little piece right here, and if I take my gummy eraser, should be able to get it off. Woohoo! It's like it's never there before. All right. So here's our outside. Now we're ready to decorate. So this little piece folds to this, and then this goes over the top. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Half inch, quarter inch. So, front cover. You kind of look at your pieces that you have and decide what you want for a front cover. And I kind of want this piece here. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it a little bit, just a little bit showing, and more on this side over here, just to give it kind of a look that I like. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add score tape. I think that this is going to have a lot of handling, so I really want to make sure that it sticks well. And now I want to find my glue. Alright, where did I throw my Tombow glue? Here it is. Nope, that's the semi-dead one. Found some big score tape. Here it is. Oof. Get out of here. I think we have used this glue till it is dead. So we will now gladly move on. About the new catalog offerings. There's a lot of new stuff. I'm in the process right now of putting together a piece. The catalog is only going to be once a year again. And there's some really cool stuff. Cricut cartridge, new... the Cricut cartridge is probably the biggest one. And then the next... The scoreboard. There's a lot of new distress tools that are coming out, which are cool. All right. But I should have next week to let people know kind of what the plan is for catalogs. And that because quite a few of you will be getting free ones, but the price of them have gone up incredible. So I'm going to have to kind of look at how to make that work for everybody. So, okay? But I don't want you to, like, not get anything for your money either. All right. So, as we open this, we're going to do the inside page here. And I think I want to use this paper for the inside page. You know, actually, I have an idea. I just have to crunch it out. But yes, for people who have not made an order of a specific amount, I need to know what that amount is in order to break even. But anybody who buys a catalog during the pre-order sale, which will probably kick off next week, will be getting a couple of bonuses. I just have to look at seeing how it all works out. So, I don't want to say too much because I definitely want to make sure I have all my details before. And since I have no kid this week, that's on my list of things to do besides purging my craft room. All right, so this is the inside email notice. So this is the inside cover. Because I want those of you who have placed orders and that to get a benefit for getting the catalog. Even if you've placed no more than a $25 order, I want to make sure that you get something out of the deal. All right. So. But I will be, for people who have made a particular purchase, they will be getting, you've spent a particular dollar amount or more, we'll be getting them free, and the and all the bonus stuff for free as well. I just have to determine which level that was. So, but there's going to be cool stuff. Everybody who gets a catalog who has placed an order, who's placed an order is going to get some bonus stuff. If you've placed at least a $25 order since January. All right. So this one I'm going to put on the inside piece, this piece here. I don't want two of my patterns together, so I need to be careful. Oh, this fly. Of course. How's everybody doing, Martha? All right, so we have our front cover, our inside cover. The other thing about adding the glue in the center is while it's wet, it's kind of warpy, but it's going to make everything so much more stiff. So that's why you put the glue and the chipboard in. All right, so I wanted this piece to go here. Because I want to put the big photo mat there, and then I have the journaling spot here on the bottom. Thank you. Mm. Oh, good. All right, so now we have our cover, our inside, the first flap, this piece. Now what we need to do is the remaining three pieces here. Yep, I think that's it. Aw. I'm glad. You know, it's not a hard project. It's something really simple. It's something you could easily throw together. You could throw a gift card in it. You can, you know, it's just a nice little something. You can gussy up as much as you want or play it down as much as you want. My friend and I tomorrow are going to do Tanya Gibbs over on YouTube and Ustream. I think she's Psycho Mom. Anyway, I think she streams on Monday nights about the same time I do. Anyway, she did a mixed media piece for Faber Castell. And I am playing with a friend tomorrow and we're going to do that. Like idea. And I think if you look at a lot of my photographs, and I'll grab a photograph from when I was little, I was trying to think of what was important at my grandpa's house, because his house always felt like home. Being that my parents were military, it was always a stable place. It very rarely changed, but it was always home. It was the one place where we knew that we were grounded. And so I was trying to figure out what it was that kind of made it homey, besides my grandparents, of course. And I came up with it was the fireplace. And there are so many photos of things happening in front of that fireplace throughout my history. My parents got married in front of the fireplace. My Christmas always took place in front of the fireplace. Any major milestones happened in front of the fireplace. And so the cool part is that I have a couple of photos of the fireplace. And I think that that's what I'm going to use in order to kind of do my piece and kind of talk about why that was important. So that was kind of neat. So, I'm really excited. So, I just needed to answer something really quick. So, yeah, I'm really kind of excited about kind of doing a mixed media piece with the fireplace. So, So anyway, I'm pretty excited about it. And I'm looking forward to doing it. Just because it's got lots of really cool techniques and stuff. But, you know, there are pictures of me and my cousin sitting on the fireplace, on the hearth, and everything. It's just a cool... That was the memory of the house. All right. So, being sneaky. All right. All right, guys. Two more pieces and we're all done. Putting our bases on. And this is going to make this really sturdy. All right. Yeah, one more piece. All right. So my number was 22, which puts it at Twisted One. And honestly, I cannot for the life of me remember your first name. Save my life. So I'm going to need you to send me a PM and let me know where I'm mailing stuff to, because you want another kit. You'll have to watch the video in order to put it together, since I already gave the sample away. But I at least have videos. So, Roxanne, awesome. I have one more coming, Mickey. Oh, it's a big old fly with a green body. So send me a PM with your information. And I will get that out to you. Because I don't think you've placed an order with me before. So I don't think I have your information. All right. And our last piece. All right. Let's write Roxanne's number on that one. Roxanne. All right, so now we have our thingy covered. We've got front cover, inside, open. We're good to go. Okay? So, the first piece that we definitely know, moving my crazy whatevers those are. The first piece I'd like to place is this one here. Now, because this is sweet leaf on some sweet leaf, I am going to want to take my Distress ink in chocolate. These are the little Distress inks from Close to My Heart. They're the chalk inks. And I'm just going to distress my edges to make this piece pop. And then what I'm going to do is grab this big ol' huge honking thing that is Martha's favorite. And I'm going to add adhesive. Maybe. Oh, look at that. It's a big ol' honking thing of adhesive. I got it. Thank you. All right, so we're going to go ahead and lay down this one. And just by adding that distressing around, I have a hard time. It's so big. All right, so now we have our photo mat here, and we have a journaling spot here. The next thing I was thinking we would put in, I'm going to go ahead and ink the edges of all of it as well, is our waterfall pieces. I just want to make sure they're all going to fit in here because, you know, what I did before and now is something different. Oh. Oh, we might actually be able to get a couple more in. Let's see. One, two, we can get three more in with this one. Okay. So what we're doing is we're just kind of, oh, and I forgot to ink those. There's one. So I'm just inking the edges of all of these pieces. You can be as light or as heavy on them as you want. Princess is fabulous, and my brother coming for the funeral and everything was really nice. He was able to show us some of her tricks. So that was really, really good. We need three more of these things, I think. I'm gonna pull a lot of photos in there. Have to cut them down just a little because these are 3.5 by 5 pieces. So let's see, we can get, I think we said three more. So I was gonna do I need a brown. She is too funny. 3.5 by 5.5. She's fun. However, she really thought I'd gone too far when I decided to dress her up. And, to dress her up and all right, I need a juniper piece. Haha. There's two, juniper and sweet leaf, if I've got enough of that. Nope. I have either gray, I think it's going to be. All right. It was funny. She just looked at me like I was crazy. And she played along with it. She's not wearing any clothes now. All right. I got to score these at 1/2 inch again. All right. Her name is Tina or Tanya Gibbs, G-I-B-B-S, and she is over on YouTube. But I'm looking forward to playing with that. So I figured I'd play with that and show everybody that tomorrow. I'm going to play upstairs just because it's easier. I'm going to run up and down the stairs all day, I'm sure. So we decided this one goes on top. I think she's here on Ustream, too. I think you can just type her name. I think it's PSH. Sorry. There you go. Yeah, she did this really, really cool layout. More masculine. Thought it'd be perfect for the fireplace. All right. And they're not even perfectly lined up. It is psycho, Mom. There we go. So we're kind of lined up, kind of a little crooked. Nobody's gonna know. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we can do another photo here. So that's cool. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17 photos in this little flippy doo. And now as it fills up, it's starting to not be as collapsy. Okay. So now what we have are our photo mats. These will become pockets. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight fit in there really nicely. Pretty excited. All right. Let's see here. I'm not sure if I'm going to use these on this page yet. I'm going to do something. But I'm going to go ahead and ink the edges of these. right, and we're going to go ahead and glue these pieces down. All right, so now what we have are our little envelopes, which go here. Oh, and those will fit nicely. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and ink the edges of all of these. So I got to watch Sunday's episode of Big Brother yesterday, or this morning. Got caught up on that. All right. Martha is a super fan. I like it a lot. Buddy, enough. Hi, Barb. Yeah, I think he's on his way out. He's a little scary. I really like Natalie. Buddy, go. Buddy, go. Dave.
Bye, Mom.
Thank you. All right. Oh, yay! That's my favorite, too. Nicole. Oh. Nicole is my favorite. Pow Pow is just Pow. The only other one that I really like is Donnie, but Nicole is my favorite. Yes, reality TV, summertime is set in. So Barb, tomorrow I'm going to make a mess with my friend Julie. We're going to play and create and make a huge mess. Okay, maybe it'll turn into art. I'm gonna mix media, play, and all kinds of stuff. I'm gonna make a mess. A hot mess. This stuff calls for stenciling and spraying and spackling and painting and gelatoing and meshing and metal and photographs and gonna be messy. One of my friends is going to come over and we're going to play. I'm sure it will be fun. It'll be like kindergarten at my house. Did I get the top of that one? I did. Alright, so here is this part of the envelopes. They are all done. Yeah, I think actually Tanya Gibbs is kind of who we're modeling after. She did a really good video. Oh, wow. We shall see what it turns out to be. Yeah. this is after two attempts to get the right size and the right way and stuff. Yeah. I'm just gonna go with it. I'm not a big messy person either, but, you know, I think that fireplace layout is really what it needs to be. All right, let's see. So we can do a 2-inch tag to slide out the side of those. Oh, wow. All right, so these are going here. Make sure I got enough. These are a little bigger than the other ones because I still haven't figured out my scoreboard or my punch board. All right, and envelopes. And the last envelope. All right, so here we have all of our bones in our book. All right. The bones of our book. We open and we've got our three little envelopes that we can put little cards in. So we're going to do that. And then along the sides, we can slip some little tags in. We have our photo mat and a journal spot. Open again. We have a photo mat, and this is supposed to have photo mats on it. Those are these two pieces here. So if you don't have a pattern that you don't want to cover up or that kind of stuff, I might cut these down a little bit. Okay. And then open again. We have our 8 flaps for our photos. And then 2 more here. I suggest doing the Cricut for the envelopes because really that was hard. All right. So are we ready to decorate? When is that going to be, Dawn? So. Oh, so you guys like have a month. That's it. All right. My son is awesome. He's at camp this week. So, my number was number 8. And Pam chose it. Woohoo! Okay, so winner, winner, chicken dinner. All I can think of is the YouTube lady who just laughs. She laughs like, and she says, winner, winner, chicken dinner. And she is laughing the whole time she talks. I don't know why that popped in my head, but you'll have to watch the video in order to make the kit because, honest, I gave the other one away. So, it's linked on my blog, or on my Facebook and my blog, I think. So, there's a video that shows how to make that. All right, guys. Stacy, there you go. She's from... yeah. Yay! All right, guys. So now we get to play and have some fun. All right. So I have some embellishments and we can make some flowers and all kinds of goodies because now the end is there. We have all those little pieces. We've got twist ties. We have paper. We can punch things. Not each other. Yeah, it is. I just have to laugh because that's just what popped in my head. And she just laughs and laughs and laughs and laughs the whole entire time. All right. So I do know what I want to do with a couple of these pieces. So this is just the scrap pieces from the pieces that we cut to make our little book. These little flowers, I don't know. But I want to use the big flowers in order to be on these cute little envelopes. So we've got one. We've got two. And three. See, those look so cute there. Yep, she does. I just have to laugh because it just makes me laugh. All right, guys, here's what I'm going to do with these. Some of these are just way too big to use in this, but I'm going to pop them all out. Because I will use them if I pop them all out. You make me laugh. Look at a cute little bird. Yeah, I did see that. That she was doing a Sizzix die sale or something coming up. She's got a huge die wall. It's like huge. I saw her at CHA actually doing videos of the different products and stuff. I was actually standing in a booth. I was standing in the Graphic 45 booth when she came by the last day of the show in order... in order to do the thing with Graphic 45, and she was just, it was just funny to hear her. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. All right. Now I have all these pieces out. I got birds and all kinds of stuff. I think I'm going to go ahead and use this chipboard, which it says, the best kind of friend is the kind you can sit on a porch swing with, never say a word, and then walk away feeling like it was the best conversation you've ever had. And so right now I'm just inking the edges. I'm going to find some foam and pop it up, and I'm going to use that on this page here. So I'm just going to go ahead and place my chipboard, and then we're going to go back and I think we'll make some flowers and stuff. All I can think of is winner, winner, chicken dinner. You guys haven't listened to her. You should pop a link up so everybody can at least see her. She's just a riot. There you go. Scrapbooking made simple. All right, our big photo, there is a picture perfect. It's kind of like a frame that goes here in the corner. So I'm going to go ahead and do that one. Oh, there you go. She's a riot, you guys. You do smile. If you're annoyed, it's one of those videos you quickly pass. Because you won't be annoyed anymore. Alright, I have to dig over here for a few more pop-ups. Here we go. I love the flowers on the envelopes. Those turned out really cute. I really liked that idea. If I do say so myself. There we go. Might be a little big. I love this little bird cage. I don't know that it's gonna fit. You're welcome! I love the book. It turned out really cute. Night, Barb. I'm liking this one. All right, I got a little ooze there. All right. Okay. Oh. I just having a ball. She at least makes me laugh. I put some little pop dot thingies. I'm just gonna put those up there like so. So now we have we have this side over here. And I think, I know you guys are going to die when I see, when I do this, but I'm going to cut this down. Oh, you're fine. You're fine. I could have fixed it at any time. You're fine. I love it when people have an opportunity to share some of the stuff that they find that's just good. And so, so I'm just cutting off the ends of these little swirly things. Oh, no biggie. Honest, I'm good. I'd tell you if I wasn't. Or if you posted a link to something I didn't want there. So, I'm good. No, no political links. All right. So now I'm doing a major taboo kind of thing. I'm using score tape to put this chipboard down. And then I'm putting the chipboard down. I'm going to use it to put tags in underneath, which is why I only did one little piece. So, let's make a few tags. It's turned out really cute, you guys. Oh, it's a little bulky now. I'll have to find a tie or something. All right, so let's see. Loving it. And I have these little twisty ties. let's make some tags. Big brother. It's summer reality TV that my family doesn't like. Except Harrison and I watch it together, so I guess, you know. What's the... I wondered about that with the 8-page flip. Oh, you know what? That's not the thing. It's all of the pop dots that I put in. Might have to go flatten a few embellishments. Oh, Harrison and I watch it together. I think these guys. Yeah, it's these guys that made everything way too tall. I think if I flatten these down. Yeah, except for if I do it right in the middle with a little bit of glue, they'll slide in too. Or I'll just cut the picture down. There we go. Just a line right across. Just like so. Ugh. I'm kind of like the double HOH, though. I do like that this season. I thought that was pretty clever. All right, much, much better. The only other pop that might be this one here. I might want to take that one down. And again, I can do exactly the same thing. I can just run glue right along the edges and my photo will slide right under. Oh, really? I thought that was awesome. Got my ruler again. Well, you know what? I love the fact that they have to, like, pick on each other all week. Nobody's really ever safe. And that's really cool. Oh, crap. All right, so I just did the edges. Because then my photo will slip right underneath there anyway. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about that tomorrow. At least my friend Julie and I. Julie is a little more adventurous. Head of household. All right. Much, much better. You interviewed for the show? Oh. Wow. Cool. That's pretty awesome. right? These tags are too different. Too big. Do you want to cut them in half, maybe? What do I want to do? What do I want to do? I'm going to take a half an inch off of these. At least two of these. I'm gonna cut them down, and then they should. So these two have little, they might actually do, so what are these? 2.5. So let's do 2 inches, and these are 3. So let's do 3/4, because that would look cute. Good night. Hope you join us again. Me too. Me too. That would be fun. Alright. Let me look here. I'm going to look for a punch that's old and totally stamping up. But I like it. It's up there, no? Punches in my house, ladies, not in your house, but in my house. Well, I guess we're just going to corner around everything. Okay, so those will go there. All right, so let's see here. Oh, what do I have for ribbon? Let's see. I think I have some twill. I have a ton of coffee bean ribbon. Oh, you know what? I've got that ribbon. That ribbon's cute. This. I don't know if I want to do. Let me look, because I know I have. Baker's twine. That would work. That would look nice. Twine and eyelets. Oh, these would be fun too. Wow. Alright. I'm thinking these might be a little big. But I do have these things from Prima that we can spray. Maybe we'll just punch holes and tie them in, I guess. A 1/8 hole. Yeah, that does that for me. Yes, I am recording because you guys are all chatting now. Mm. Oh, you know, I met Zandra at CHA, and she is great. You'll have a good time. And I just punched that in the wrong spot. Good thing those have wide flanges on them. Oh, is my time safe? Yeah, I should be fine. Guys will never believe this. I heard, I'm looking for my thing right now, that where is it? My trusty edge distressor has a separate purpose, you guys. I just need to find it. Here it is. Here's one. I learned today on a video from Close to My Heart, you guys will never guess, you can sharpen your scissors with a sharpening tool. That was bizarre, but it worked. That was on a video today. These trusty little $2.95 edge distressor thingies. Yeah. I was on a corporate video today. Then I'm gonna try and set those up. Yeah. Come on, where is the end? Okay. I don't know. The corporate video for Close to My Heart, the edge distressors that are purple, and I have a purple one, and this is an old white one, but that you can use them to sharpen your scissors. Had no clue about that. All right. Yep, now I'd find the end, right? Voila. That might be kind of pretty. Our little one here. You know, maybe I should just do... Oh, that whole big bag is full to go out.
Okay.
I did do part of it today. All right. So anyway, I'm just kind of finishing up and just playing a little. Gonna put the finishing touches on this stuff. But like I said, the bare bones of the album are all fun. And then kind of decorating however you want. How would you live without your scrapbook crap for that long? Don't know that I could. I'd have to take it all with me. Harrison would definitely not allow me to do Big Brother. He'd be like, no. I could hear him now. Well, and there's a ton of paper left, so you can easily make cards. All kinds of stuff. Oh, I'll be the daughter who'll talk to you about it, Martha. Not that I could replace her, but I definitely could be a daughter. I'm parentless now. Grandparentless, too. Okay, I take that back. Dave's parents are still here, and I really like them, so. You'd also have to disappear for quite a while, and we'd have to wonder what happened. They got little tags that slip in behind the envelopes for more little pieces. I have this green, I've taken a class from L'Amour at CHA twice now. This has been in my stash forever. Now I'm ripping it apart. Yay, so I think I'm going to put that on the front. I'm going to do some flowers. I think I'm going to use that, because I really like that. So how about we make some flowers? Oh, yay! The class that I took with L'Amour is this one right here. He took this class with her. I don't know, I kind of want that to go below. So anyway, this is chalkboard paint and whip spackle and all kinds of good stuff. Are you going to bed?
Soon.
Oh, it's only 8:30.
Yep.
Yay! So anyway, I'm going to make some flowers. But I think I want to stop the video. Just because I want to make sure that everything kind of goes well with the video. So, I'm going to do a last walkthrough on the video, and then I'm going to stay on and make some more flowers and things for the front. But I'll just do the I'll do the photos on my blog. So this is the front, and we're going to add a resin frame that's been in my stash forever. And I think we're going to add some flowers and some things, hide this bird that's got no head, that kind of stuff. Open it up, and we have three envelopes that allow us to do some little pullouts there. And then we have our three little tags on the side for journaling or for pictures or little pieces. We have our large photo mat here and place for journaling. You open it up again, we have two photos for this page that'll slip underneath these since we only glued in the middle. We have our kind of layout page that we'll add some more flowers and things to. We have our 8-page flip. This will allow us to have 16 different photos. And then we have our little tags that have our baker's twine. It's more like embroidery floss on it with our little tags here. So you can do some photos, some different things like that. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the video. You can find all this information over on my blog at scrapandstampcreations.blogspot.com or join us over on my Facebook page, which is Scrap and Stamp Creations over on Facebook. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next week.